Welcome all in this second lecture. Today we will see degree of static indeterminacy. So what is mean by degree of static indeterminacy and how degree of static indeterminacy is calculated for beam. In today's lecture we will see the beam part and in next lecture we will see the frame and truss. Okay, so what is mean by static indeterminacy? So first of all we will revise the some concept of structure analysis 1. What are the equilibrium equations of static equilibrium? If you are considering the plane frame or plane structure, so equations of equilibrium are summation fx equal to 0, summation fy equal to 0 and summation m equal to 0. This is for a 2d frame or 2d structure. But if you are considering the 3d structure, so there are 6 equations, summation fx equal to 0, fy equal to 0, fz is equal to 0 and mx equal to 0, my equal to 0 and mz equal to 0. So there will be 6 equations for 3D structure or space frame. Now what is mean by static indeterminacy? See here, this is a simply supported beam. And suppose I have to calculate the unknown reactions for this beam. So how many unknown reactions will be here? So this is hinge support, so there will be 2 reactions. This is roller support, so there will be only 1 reaction. So total reactions for this beam will be 3. And how many equations we have, equations of static equilibrium to solve or to calculate these reactions? This is a plane structure, plane beam. So we have 3 equations. Summation fx equal to 0, fy equal to 0 and m equal to 0. So 3 equations and these 3 reactions. 3 equations, 3 reactions can be analyzed. We know that suppose we have to find out the 2 unknowns, we need 2 equations. Suppose we have to find out 3 unknowns, we need 3 equations. We have solved the simultaneous equations in that we have seen. Suppose x plus y is equal to 4. And x plus 2y is equal to 10. And in that case, we have 2 equations. We can solve the, we can calculate the value of x and value of y. So here are 3 unknowns we can solve, or we can calculate these reactions by using 3 equations. Now similarly, this is second beam, which is fixed cantilever beam, means one end is fixed and other end is free. So this is cantilever beam. It is cantilever beam, not fixed beam. Fixed beam means it is fixed at both ends. So there is one correction. So it is cantilever beam. So how many unknown reactions will be here? Again 3 reactions, because this is fixed support. We know that if the fixed support is there, fixed support offers 3 reactions. One vertical, second horizontal and third is movement reaction. So 3 reactions will be there. Okay. So again we can use 3 equations of equilibrium and we can solve it. Okay. So this and this, both these structures are determinant, because with the help of only equilibrium equation we can analyze it. Okay. Now look at this beam. This is continuous beam, and let us calculate the reactions for this beam. So this is hinge support, this is also hinge support and this is roller support. So hinge support will offer 2 reactions. This hinge support will offer 2 reactions. So 2 plus 2, 4. And this roller support will offer 1 reaction. So 2 plus 2 plus 1. So total reactions component for this beam is 5. But we have only 3 equations. So it is not possible to calculate all the reactions by using 3 equations, because unknowns are 5 and we have only 3 equations. So here this beam is not determinant beam. This is indeterminant beam. Similarly, you can see here for this fixed beam, at this fixed support 3 reactions, at this second fixed support again 3 reactions, one vertical, horizontal and movement. Similarly here, one vertical, horizontal and movement. So total reaction component for this fixed beam, 6 reactions and we have 3 equations. So is it not possible to calculate all the reactions by using equations of equilibrium. So this is also indeterminate structure. This frame is also indeterminate. Now see, from this example you can differentiate what is mean by determinant and what is mean by indeterminate. If any structure which can be analyzed with the help of equations of equilibrium, then it is determinant structure. If any structure whose reaction components or internal forces cannot be calculated by using equations of equilibrium, then it is indeterminant. He doni structure indeterminant hai, and he doni structure determinant hai. So determinant and indeterminant yatla doni itla tumhala farak samjavun ghyaycha asel, to tumhala tithle unknown kiti ahet ते identify karayla lagtil. आणि अननोन समजा अवेलेबल इक्वेशन्स पेक्षा जास्त असतील तर ते स्ट्रक्चर किंवा तो बीम ती फ्रेम तुमची इनडिटर्मिनंट असेल. नंबर ऑफ इक्वेशन्स अवेलेबल आणि नंबर ऑफ अननोन्स दोन्ही सेम असतील तर तुमचं स्ट्रक्चर डिटर्मिनंट आहे. ओके, दीज आर द डेफिनेशन्स. स्ट्रक्चर दॅट कॅन बी अनालाइज विथ द हेल्प ऑफ स्टॅटिक इक्विलिब्रियम इक्वेशन्स अलोन इज स्टॅटिकली डिटर्मिनंट स्ट्रक्चर. सो एक्झाम्पल, सिम्पली सपोर्टेड बीम अँड फिक्स्ड बीम. And statically indeterminate structure, any structure whose reaction component or internal forces cannot be calculated by using equations of equilibrium alone, that is your statically indeterminate structure. Okay, this is also an example of indeterminate frame. So those who have already forgotten the basic concept of structure analysis 1, so for these students, see, this is hinge support will offer two reaction, roller support will offer one reaction, and fixed support will offer three reactions. So this will offer only vertical reaction, this will offer vertical as well as horizontal, and this will offer vertical, horizontal and a moment reaction. So please remember this because it is very useful for this particular chapter and for entire structure analysis too. Okay, now what is mean by degree of static indeterminacy? Now it is clear to all of you that what is indeterminate structure and what is determinant structure. Now what is degree of static indeterminacy means what? See, number of equation in addition to the static equations necessary to completely analyze the statically indeterminate structure, it's called as degree of static indeterminacy. म्हणजे काय बघा, आता हे फिक्स्ड बीम पहा, हाउ मेनी रिएक्शन्स ऍट दिस फिक्स्ड सपोर्ट, थ्री रिएक्शन्स. हाउ मेनी रिएक्शन्स हियर, अगेन थ्री रिएक्शन्स. सो 1 2 3 1 2 3 3 3 सिक्स रिएक्शन्स अँड इक्वेशन्स अवेलेबल ओनली थ्री. So for 6 unknown to calculate, we need 6 equations, but available equations are only 3. So how many extra equations are required? We need 3 equations extra. Total 6 equations required. Suppose, see, 6 unknowns are there, means you need 6 equations. So only 3 equations are there. So additional equations, how many required? So 3 equations. So that 3 means a degree of static indeterminacy. Similarly, for this continuous beam, here 2 reactions, here also 2 reaction, 1 reaction. So 2 plus 2 plus 1, so total 5 reactions are there and equations are 3. So 5 minus 3, 2 extra equations are required to analyze this beam completely. To analyze this beam completely means 2 is the degree of static indeterminacy for this particular beam. Okay. Now see again this definition of degree of static indeterminacy. Number of equations in addition to static equilibrium equations required or necessary to completely analyze the statically indeterminate structure is called as degree of static indeterminacy. So in simplified formula I have written here, ds is number of unknowns minus number of equations available. This is general equations. So what is there in unknown? अननोन म्हणजे काय, तर आतापर्यंत आपण फक्त बघितलं की रिएक्शन कंपोनंट, फक्त रिएक्शन कंपोनंट अननोन होते का? नाही. सी व्हेन वी आर अनालायझिंग द फ्रेम इन स्ट्रक्चरल अनालिसिस वन, सो हाऊ मेनी अननोन्स वेअर देअर? सी फर्स्ट वी आर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग द रिएक्शन्स, रिएक्शन कंपोनंट ऍट इच सपोर्ट. नाऊ हिअर आर थ्री रिएक्शन्स. देन वी आर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग द एक्झियल फोर्स डायग्राम और FBD डायग्राम फॉर इच मेंबर. सो वी वेर कन्सिडरिंग इच मेंबर सेपरेटली अँड वी वेर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग और वी आर ड्रॉइंग द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम फॉर इच मेंबर सेपरेटली. सो अननोन मीन्स नॉट ओनली द एक्सटर्नल रिएक्शन, अननोन मीन्स दिस रिएक्शन ॲट दिस जॉईंट, रिएक्शन ॲट दिस मीन्स एक्झियल फोर्स, शिअर फोर्स अँड बेंडिंग मुवमेंट, दीज आर ऑल्सो अननोन्स. ओके, अननोन्स मीन्स नॉट ओनली दिस रिएक्शन्स, अननोन मीन्स एक्झियल फोर्स, we are drawing axial force diagram, we are drawing bending moment diagram, we are drawing shear force diagram. The shear force, axial force, bending moment हे सुद्धा काय आहेत, अननोन्स आहेत. त्याला आपण म्हणायचं इंटरनल फोर्सेस आणि ह्या ज्या रिएक्शन्स आहेत त्याला आपण म्हणायचं एक्सटर्नल रिएक्शन्स. म्हणजे अननोन मध्ये दोन पॅरामीटर येणार आहेत, एक म्हणजे एक्सटर्नल रिएक्शन्स आणि दुसरं म्हणजे इंटरनल फोर्सेस, दॅट इज एक्झियल फोर्स, शेअर फोर्स अँड बेंडिंग मुवमेंट. ओके, so for each member you will get three internal forces, axial force, shear force, the axial force, shear force and bending moment. For each member you will get three reactions, three internal forces, and external reaction will depend upon the support, which type of support it is there. Okay, now just look at this beam, this frame. Now here are three unknowns, here are three unknowns, but these are external reactions, but internal reactions, again each member will carry three internal forces, each member will carry three internal forces, axial force, shear force and bending moment. Okay, now when we will considering the static degree of static indeterminacy, we have to count that internal forces also in the unknown parameter, in the unknown. So for that, and to calculate the degree of static indeterminacy, we will calculate in an approach where we will calculate degree of static indeterminacy for external, means for reaction, separately, and degree of static indeterminacy for internal forces separately. So how will you calculate this? See, TS is equal to DSE plus DSI. Please lakshya dhya ithe baka, external forces म्हणजे आपली आपण रिएक्शन कन्सिडर करणार आहोत आणि इंटरनल फोर्सेसमध्ये शेअर फोर्स, बेंडिंग मुवमेंट अँड एक्झियल फोर्स, हे तीन फोर्सेस कन्सिडर करणार आहोत. आता ज्यावेळी हे आपण कॅल्क्युलेट करतोय, त्या डिग्री कॅल्क्युलेट करताना आपण डीएसई आणि डीएसआय हे दोन्ही सेपरेट कॅल्क्युलेट केले. याचं कारण काय आहे? कारण इंटरनल फोर्सेस सेपरेट आहेत, एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस सेपरेट आहेत. सो आपण असा अप्रोच ज्यावेळी डिग्री कॅल्क्युलेट करू त्यावेळी त्या अप्रोचने कॅल्क्युलेट करू की डीएस इज इक्वल टू डीएसई प्लस DSI घेताना आपण इंटरनल फोर्सेस कन्सिडर करायचे आणि DSE घेताना एक्सटर्नल. DSI मीन्स डिग्री ऑफ स्टॅटिक इनडिटर्मिनसी फॉर इंटरनल फोर्सेस अँड DSE मीन्स डिग्री ऑफ स्टॅटिक इनडिटर्मिनसी फॉर एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस. ओके, नाउ हाउ विल यू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस, हाउ विल यू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस? सो दिस इज अ सिंपल बीम विच इज कंटिन्युअस. हाउ विल यू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस? So degree of total degree of static indeterminacy DS will be equal to DSE plus DSI. Now what is DSE? It's reaction minus number of equations available. जसं मी तुम्हाला आता सांगितलं की किती reactions आहेत total minus number of equations available. So number of reactions here for this particular beam is 2, 1 and 2. This is hinge support, so 2 reaction, roller support 1 reaction. Again hinge support 2 reactions, so 2 plus 1 plus 2, so total reactions over here is 5. How many number of members? 1 and 1, so total 2 members. And how many joints are there? So joints 1, 2 and 3. So 3 joints. Okay. So how will you calculate DSE? DSE will calculate R minus 3, means simple reaction minus the equations available. So you will get external degree of indeterminacy. Now how will you calculate DSI? DSI is equal to 3m, 3 into 3 multiplied by members, means how many each member will carry 3 internal forces, so 3m, so this is unknown, minus 3 into joints. See, for each joint you will apply one equation of equilibrium. See, we have seen in the analysis of frame in structure analysis 1, for each joint you can apply 3 equations. For this particular joint you can apply summation fx equal to 0, summation fy equal to 0 and summation m equal to 0. For each joint you can apply 3 equations. So 3 multiplied by 3j, 3 multiplied by joints minus 3. So this is equations, these are the equations available for analyzing the internal forces, and these are the internal forces 3 multiplied by m. So again, for this particular beam, how will you calculate degree of static indeterminacy? How many members? 2. How many joints? 3. 1, 2 and 3. So you put all these value in equation, 3 multiplied by m, 3 multiplied by 2, minus 3 into 3 minus 3. Okay. So if you calculate this, 3 multiplied by 2 minus 3 into 3, this is 0. And DSE is 2. So 2 plus 0, total degree of static indeterminacy is 2. Generally for beam, this degree of static indeterminacy internal is 0. Because for beam, if you calculate these reactions, then you can easily calculate the shear force, axial force and bending moment. If you calculate the reaction, then you can calculate the SFD, AFD and BFD easily. So that's why this DSI for beam is 0. So now see here, it is 0. Many times it is 0. But you have to calculate DSE. Simply you have to calculate reactions minus equations 3, you will get the DSE. Now we'll solve one more example. Now we'll go to the next part, that is what is mean by internal hinge or what is mean by internal link. See, before that, see, this is simplified formula for the DS, that is DS is equal to 3m plus r minus 3j. See, DSE, this is derived from this two equations. This is derived from this two equations. I have given the simplification over here. See, DSE plus DSI, DSE is 3m minus 3j minus 3, and what is DSI? Sorry, this is DSI, 3m minus 3j minus 3, and this is DSE r minus 3. So this minus 3 plus 3 and this minus 3 will be get cancelled. This is 3m plus r minus 3j. If you simplify this, you will get 3m plus r minus 3j. So this is simplified formula for beam. Okay, this is simplified formula for beam as well as frame. So if you forgot these two formulas, then you can use this simplified formula, that is 3m plus r minus 3j, that is degree of static indeterminacy DS for beam. But in exam they will ask you to draw or to calculate DSE and DSI separately. So in that case you have to calculate separately. Next is internal hinge. What is mean by internal hinge? So suppose a hinge is provided anywhere in the structure which cannot transmit the movement from one part of the structure to other part, and hence it provides one additional equation, summation m equal to 0. So we have seen this in structure analysis 1 also. Means suppose there is internal hinge in between the frame, so in that case you will get one more equation, summation mc equal to 0. So now what is the effect of this internal hinge on the degree of static indeterminacy DS? So as I have told you that it will give you one additional equation. Means what? We have three equilibrium equation and this one additional equation. So total equilibrium equation will be increased by one. So instead of this Ra minus 3, your equation will become 3 plus 1. Means, if you are having one internal hinge, so 1. Suppose you are having two internal hinges, 2. Let this Hn be the number of internal hinges, then this Dsc will be equal to R minus 3 plus Hn. What is Hn? Hn is the number of internal hinges. Suppose there are 3 internal hinges here. So, R minus in bracket 3 plus 3. So, 3 plus 3 is 6 and R is 3. So, 3 minus 6. So, it's minus 3. This will become minus 3. And DSI will remain same. The degree of static indeterminacy internal, this will remain same as usual. That is 3M minus 3J minus 3. Okay. Only change in DSE, degree of static indeterminacy external. Okay, please remember this internal hinge. If internal hinge is there, only one equation will be added in number of equilibrium equations. Suppose three equations are there and you have two internal hinges, then 3 plus 2, then 3 plus 2. If you are having one internal hinge, 3 plus 1. If you are having three internal hinges, 3 plus 3. So, how many internal hinges are there? You have to just count. And you have to add in the number of equations available, that is 3. So this let this formula you have to remember, R minus 3 plus Hn, where Hn is the number of internal hinges. Suppose an internal link is there. What is mean by internal link? See, this is a short bar with a pin joint at both the ends. This is short bar, pin jointed here and pin jointed here. This is called as internal link. Now suppose a link is provided anywhere in the structure which is incapable of transmitting the moment as well as horizontal force. So see, internal hinge is not capable of transferring the moment, but this link is not capable of transferring moment as well as horizontal force. So this link will give you two additional equations. Means suppose one link is there, you will get two additional equations. Okay. So let this Ln be the number of links. So what will be the change in degree of static indeterminacy external? So DSE is equal to R minus into bracket 3 plus 2 Ln. So 2 Ln means one link is there, you will get two additional equations. Two link is there, you will get four additional equations. So DSE will change R minus into bracket 3 plus 2 Ln. Okay. Now DSI will again remain same as usual, that is 3m minus into bracket 3j minus 3. Okay, so this is what about the beam with the internal link and internal hinge. Suppose both the parameters are there, that is internal hinge is also there and link is also there. So in that case, what will be the degree of static indeterminacy external? R minus into bracket 3 plus Hn plus 2 Ln. Okay, so and DSI will remain as usual. So now we'll solve an example. Okay, so this is fixed roller, then hinge support with link, and we have to calculate the degree of static indeterminacy for this particular beam. So first you have to calculate number of members. So this is one member. From here to here, one member, and from here to here, one member. So number of members, 2. So how many joints are there? 1, 2, and 3. See, for this particular link, don't consider it as a joint. So consider, because we are taking equation separately, so don't consider it as a joint. And you have to consider this particular member from here to here as one member. So number of members, 2, and joint, 3. Reactions, 2 plus 1 plus 3. 3 reaction at fixed support, 1 reaction at roller support, and 2 reaction at hinge support. So 2 plus 1 plus 3. So total reaction 6. Number of joints 1, 2, 3. And number of member 2. So our approach is DSE is equal to DSE plus DSI. So what is DSE? As there is a link, so DSE formula will be R minus into bracket 3 plus 2 Ln. So R is 6. Minus 3 plus how many links are there? Only one link, so Ln is 1. 2 into 1. So this will be 1. DSE, degree of static indeterminacy external, it is 1. Now what is DSI, degree of static indeterminacy internal? So 3 into member M minus 3 into J minus 3, this will remain same. So 3 into M is 2 minus 3 into joint 3 minus 3. So 6 minus 6, 0. So degree of static indeterminacy internal, 0. Degree of static indeterminacy external, 1. So DS is equal to 1 plus 0, 1. So we have the degree of static indeterminacy for this particular beam is 1. Now if you consider the second beam with internal hinge, again DSE formula will be R minus 3 plus HN. As there is internal hinge, so there will be change. Okay, so 3 plus 2 plus 1, so R is 6, HN internal hinges 1, joint 1 2 3, so 3 joint, member this is 1 member and this is 2 member. हा पूर्ण मेंबर तुम्हाला कन्सिडर करायचा आहे, मधला जो जॉईंट आहे हा जॉईंट कन्सिडर करायचा नाही किंवा हे दोन मेंबर सेपरेटली कन्सिडर करायचे नाही. सो मेंबर 2 जॉईंट 3 HN 1 R इज इक्वल टू 6. सो इफ यू सबस्टिट्यूट ऑल द व्हॅल्यूज हियर यू विल गेट डिग्री ऑफ स्टॅटिक इंडिटर्मिनसी एक्सटर्नल 2. अँड हियर DSI 3 M मायनस 3 J इंटू 3. सो M इज 2 मायनस 3 इंटू 3 मायनस 3. सो 6 मायनस 6 इज इक्वल टू 0. And total degree of static indeterminacy 0, 2 plus 0 is equal to 2. Okay. So this is how you can calculate the degree of static indeterminacy for beam. For beam, calculation of degree of static indeterminacy is very simple. Without any calculation also you can calculate the degree of static indeterminacy by just calculating the number of reactions minus number of equations. Okay. So for this beam particularly we will apply here. So 3 plus 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2 5 plus 1 6, so reactions 6. So how many equations? We have 3 equations but there is one internal hinge, so one equation addition, so total 4 equations. So 6 reactions minus 4 equation, degree of static indeterminacy is 2. By direct approach degree of static indeterminacy is 2. But I have purposefully introduce this formula because this approach is very essential, because when you calculate the frame there will be little bit confusion, there will be little bit complications in this calculation, so direct approach may not be possible for frame. So for practice I have introduced these formulas and you have to remember these formulas for the calculation of degree of static indeterminacy. Again for the second frame we will apply the direct approach. So 3 reactions for fixed, so 1 and 2, so 2 plus 1 plus 3, so total 6 reactions, and equations of equilibrium 3, but this link will give additional 2, so 3 plus 2 5. So 6 reaction minus 5 equation, degree of static indeterminacy 6 minus 5 1, 6 minus 5. So means for beam calculation of degree of static indeterminacy is very simple if you use this generalized formula, that is reaction minus equations, that is enough. But only you have to understand where the how many equations are there for your particular beam, considering hinge, considering link. Okay, if link is there 2 additional equation, hinge is there 1 additional equation, that you have to consider. Okay, so this is all about the degree of static indeterminacy and we have seen only beam part. In next lecture we will see the part of frame. So for frame how will you calculate the degree of static indeterminacy? Okay, so I'll stop here and my request to all of you to practice some example for the calculation of degree of static indeterminacy for beam. Try to draw some beam with different types of support, different types of hinges, and number of hinges, number of linkage, number of links, and you have to practice to calculate DSE as well as DSI. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.